Since the beginning of time, stories have been told of the hero's journey. But before the hero, and before the journey, it all starts with one dude.
Liberty is rising. You understand how good it feels out here right now? You understand how high I am off being out here? This feels awesome. This is what it is to be alive, like our ancestors running around and stuff a lot colder than this, taking animals down and hauling them back to the women with big fires and the caves. Yeah, living. I'm out here bathing in the night. Forest bathing yesterday, this is what it's all about. I don't need drugs.
But this wasn't your typical run-of-the-mill dude, reading all the headlines like all the words were written in stone. This was Alex Jones, the most dangerous man on the internet. A man that journalists thought was so dangerous that it was in our best interest that he be silenced.
I'm talking about Alex Jones. He is the founder of InfoWars, and he is now feeling the heat himself. YouTube, Facebook, and Apple all announcing they're removing his content from their platforms. With me now, CNN Money's senior media reporter, Oliver Darcy, and you were just saying to me, you were surprised that they took this kind of action so swiftly.
Yeah, this happened very quickly over the past 24 hours. We've seen throughout the day, actually, tech platforms just basically remove Alex Jones from their websites.
Obviously, what he spews is hate, and it's abhorrent.
The problem with silencing someone like Alex is that the idea of him never goes away. It becomes cemented in history, and a legend is born.
You'll never, never defeat the human spirit! You'll never defeat God! You'll never win! Never! Ever! Never! Ever! Never! Ever!
I'm willing to do whatever it takes to stop you. And I hate your stinking guts. I can smell you from 1,000 miles away.
You think you're strong. You think you're scary. God's wrath coming for you. The reason the enemy's so mad is he knows he's a loser.
You're dead as a doornail, dead as a rotting corpse at the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean.
The reason they want to tear everything up and crap all of everything is they know they already failed, and they know they're ugly losers. And this is where we get tested. So rejoice to God Almighty for this animated contest of liberty.
After being shut down, Alex decided it was time to go to Washington and face down those responsible and warn the American people.
You are incredibly shameful, man.
How are you doing, Alex?
You're just a, look at you, look, you are literally an anti-American, anti-free speech coward. Just look at this guy's eyes. That is who will ruin your life. He's even more evil looking in person.
Something to think about the decisions that you made.
You can shut everyone down on Earth. No one will like you. You understand that? You'll never have billions and billions of fans and followers. You'll never have people that love you. Just look in those eyes. The hunger to silence America. The hunger to extinguish the First Amendment.
Right.
Smiling like a possum that climbed out of the rear end of a dead cow. You look like a possum that got caught doing some really nasty stuff. In my view. You're going to go down the history books at the Criminal News Network. I mean, look at those eyes, folks. If you want to see the eyes of a rat. Seriously, look at the camera. Look at those eyes.
Google is evil. Google is evil. Google is evil.
I think it's important for them not to comply with any efforts to sort of go after freedom of
expression. What about the Democrats purging conservatives? She's not answering.
It's weird, man.
Oh, yeah, it's really weird. There's no purge of conservatives.
I don't know.
There's no shadow banning. Sundar, you will not silence the people.
There's Sundar Pichai right there.
Your censorship will not work anymore, Sundar.
Everybody should be. Look, I support
here.
Going after.
It's happening here, but you said I don't exist.
Is that a heckler or a press gaggle?
Look at this guy. He's saying that I don't exist, and they're
I just don't know who you are, man. I don't read your websites.
We're aware of your activities, trying to muzzle the American people and gaming your search results. Google is evil.
Do they need to be right?
Marco Rubio, the snake.
This is
a frat boy here.
All right, man.
Yeah.
Who are you?
Yeah,
this guy? I swear to God, I don't know
who
you are,
man. You better hope you're deplatforming. Tens of millions of views.
InfoWars.
Better than Rush Limbaugh. He knows who InfoWars is.
But
playing this joke over here. That's why the deplatforming didn't work.
But here's a question.
Hey, don't touch me again, man. I'm asking you not to touch me.
Well, sure, I'm just patting you nicely.
I know, but I don't want to be. I don't know
you.
Man. I don't know who you are.
It's not just good.
You're not
going to
get arrested,
amendment.
Man. You're not going
to
get arrested. I'll take care of it myself.
Google is evil.
Google is evil. Google is evil.
You're not going to silence me. You're not going to silence America.
No, but there are people.
You are literally like a little gangster thug.
There are people in this country.
Rubio just threatened to physically take care of me.
Eventually, he found himself in the halls of the Senate. With the eyes of the American people on him, he knew it was now or never.
Microphone,
you guys want to come around this way?
Come around.
Hey, you want to go this way?
Tell us why you're here today.
Okay, I'm going to tell you why I'm here.
Say sorry to the Sandy Hook parents, Alex.
I am here because there is a concerted effort by the Democratic Party and multinational corporations and big tech to silence conservative and nationalist and populist voices ahead of this critical midterm election. Simultaneously, four major tech giants in 24 hours admitted they colluded, violating Sherman Antitrust Act 2, bare minimum, to deplatform me for more than 20 million subscribers total. People that chose to go click and link and listen to what I was saying and what I was doing. They told 20 million subscribers, you can't go listen to Alex Jones anymore. How un-American is that? What country have we turned into where the New York Times, the Washington Post, and CNN openly lobby to take me off every platform and openly lobby that anyone that talks about Alex Jones in a positive way will then also be blacklisted off the internet? You are now evil. You are aiding and abetting evil. The real election meddling is by Facebook and Google and others that are shadow banning people, that are outright banning people. So what these big tech giants have done is gotten away with murder, violating our rights, working with communist China, suppressing populations, and just doing incredibly evil things. But because they all pose as liberal trendies and wearing, you know, funny socks, it's all supposedly cute. It's not. And the so-called press that went to journalism school is foaming at the mouth like mad Cujo dogs with rabies to tear the First Amendment apart. Remember this. You killed your profession by becoming nothing but mercenaries for the globalists, and people know that you're fake news, many of you. Now, with you trying to kill the First Amendment, you're making yourself true villains. God, you liberals are dumb. I mean, it's unbelievable, brother. You're dumber than a damn box of rocks, son, and we're getting ready to bust it all up. So keep laughing. We're going to find out, traitors. CNN is not just fake news. It's the criminal news network that works as a racketeering crime syndicate to openly shut down my media operations and other people's media operations. This is a criminal mafia that thinks they own this country. Judgment Day politically is here, and the attempts to intimidate the American people and the attempts to silence us and the attempts to bully me and others into submission to this globalist system are not going to work. And so that's why I'm here to expose this, I'm here to speak out about this, and I'm here to discuss the reality that there is an attempted purge of the First Amendment taking place in this country. The dominoes are falling, the First Amendment's being destroyed. But I think the corporate dying dinosaur media has bit off more than it can chew, and what you've done is only going to make people be that much stronger and fight for free speech that much more. Shame on the mainstream corporate media, shame on the mainstream corporate media for not defending the First Amendment, but instead attack-dogging, calling for federal regulators to shut down independent free press working with big tech. You guys attempted bullying and reign of terror against the American people's coming to an end.
Very few were willing to stand up for old Alex Jones. Like a bunch of cold, wet mice, they were scared that they too would be silenced if they dared speak out.
What we're watching now in real time is this country become unfree. So the question is, who exactly is defending us in all of this? Us who might dissent from Mark Zuckerberg's view, or don't trust Mark Zuckerberg to control what we think. What about us? Who's standing up for us? Where are our leaders in Congress? Where's the White House? Nowhere. As long as their accounts remain open, they don't seem to care. They're fools.
I believe the threats posed by Google, and to a lesser extent Facebook, are so serious that everyone needs to know about them.
Can you really win a presidential election if Google opposes you? No, you can't. Not a chance. Not right now. Without free speech, there is no democracy. It's time to stop lying about that.
This is really about the unchecked power that these big tech monopolies have over our public discourse and how this is a real threat.
You've written about the dangers of the connection between monopoly and authoritarianism.
There's a history and a track record of an economy dominated by monopoly flipping into an authoritarian form of government. And I don't think it's crazy to start becoming concerned about possible rise of fascism in our times.
Number one, in 2016, Google's search algorithm likely impacted undecided voters in a way that shifted at least 2.6 million votes to Hillary Clinton, whom I supported.
Whether you're a progressive or conservative, whether you consider yourself on the left or the right, we all have to stand united to protect our freedom of speech because, look, today it's me, tomorrow it could be you or someone else.
Yes.
Biased search results can easily produce shifts in the opinions and voting preferences of undecided voters by up to 80% in some demographic groups because people blindly trust high-ranking search results over lower ones.
This is a real threat to our freedom of speech and to our fair election. So this really isn't about me, it's about taking action on behalf of the American people. Because we've got to understand here that if Google can do this to me as a sitting member of Congress running for the highest office in the land, then that means they can do this to any candidate running for any office anywhere in this country, and frankly, to any person.
Number three, in the weeks leading up to the 2018 election, bias in Google search results may have shifted upwards of 78.2 million votes spread across many races to the candidates of one political party.
We need to be aware of the dangers of a union of private and public power. Imagine Facebook cooperating with an authoritarian regime. They know everything about us. They know what we do. They know how to influence us. If you imagine these two units working together, I think it's a very scary prospect.
Why are you the only candidate who's saying this?
You know, as a soldier, these are the principles that I stand up for, that even though you and I may disagree on things, I'm willing to give my life for your freedom to do so.
On Election Day in 2018, the Go Vote reminder that Google displayed on its homepage gave one political party at least 800,000 more votes than it gave the other party. That reminder was not a public service. It was a vote manipulation. And unlike billboards or those Russian-placed ads, these manipulations are invisible and non-competitive. They're controlled entirely by big tech companies, and there is no way to counteract them.
Google, Facebook, Twitter, these are big tech monopolies that have this unchecked power to influence our public discourse, to influence what kind of information people are seeing. Google is in control of 88% of all internet searches in the United States, and I believe it's 92% of all internet searches in the world. So it's important that Congress takes action because right now this is unchecked. They've got their secret algorithms. They can control the information that we see. They can control what pops up in our Facebook feeds, and they can censor voices that they disagree with.
If these companies all support the same candidate, they will have the power to shift 15 million votes to that candidate.
This is such an important issue that is integral to every single one of our freedoms that we cherish and that we all must stand up and protect.
To let big tech get away with subliminal manipulation on this scale would be to make the free and fair election meaningless.
And everybody's like, well, what's going on? Nothing.
Yeah.
Oh,
sure,
her
so
account
dangerous.
Got suspended. Whatever. No, they're interfering with democracy.
Yep.
You could just say they violated policy. Like, what policy? What
yep.
policy did you violate? Did they just cancel your ad?
They still have not told us that.
That's insane.
The policy
that's
you
the
violated
point.
Was being a viable candidate
yeah,
for president
right.
of the United States
it
of America.
It has to be.
Exactly.
To be.
Not
it
only a viable
be.
Candidate, but one that's saying, hey, you guys are too fucking big.
Yeah.
I'm
going to
break up these
yes.
monopolies and provide the kinds of oversight and accountability that will protect the consumer, that will protect the American people, protect fair and honest discourse, protect freedom of speech.
One of the things that they're doing is they use that blanket term hate speech.
So that's where we are, hate speech. The fuck? How come I'm not allowed to hate shit, by the way?
Right.
I hate Nazis. Can I say I hate fucking
that's
Nazis?
Hate speech.
I hate the KKK. Can I say I hate them?
That's hate
right?
speech.
I
You strongly dislike the KKK.
People go, oh, good for Alex Jones. He shouldn't be able to do that stuff, what he's doing. I'm like, do you not understand? that this is the shot across the bow, the antidote to bad speech. If you really hate what Alex Jones is doing, the antidote to bad speech is not censorship. The antidote to bad speech is more speech. If you think what Alex Jones is doing needs to be debunked, create a Facebook page called Debunking Alex Jones and debunk him. So right now we need a Teddy Roosevelt to come along and break up all these monopolies. It's never going to happen. The end of the empire is coming.
Others were bathing in celebration and rejoiced in what they considered to be a victory in the never-ending fight between the left and the right.
We've had a standard in this country. If someone is using their speech poorly, you go to court. But you're advocating for billionaire guys in Silicon Valley to decide this all on their own, and you run a fucking media company?
Yes, I am.
And that's what you're advocating
for? Yes, I am.
I want them shut down. I want them silenced. I want them muted. I think they are horrible for our society.
The right to be on a platform, that is not free speech.
So you don't think
that's
that?
That is not. We have censorship because we need censorship. We do.
We're living in a time when the constitutional protection of free speech is being exploited and purposely misunderstood by people with nefarious motives.
Am I wrong, or did you just advocate for Mark Zuckerberg being able to do this on his own, or for Google or YouTube to be able to do this with
them? They are allowed to have a process.
So you're advocating for in dark, in secret.
Why is the court better than internal process?
Hey guys, let me cut in real quick. Wow. We just got taken down by YouTube. They just killed our stream.
So you're saying that an adversarial judicial process with an impartial judge which follows the law and the Constitution is not any better than Mark Zuckerberg and
Henry Kissinger in secret deciding this shit? Totally separate. That's what you're saying?
Anytime they've considered banning him, the right wing cries about free speech violations, even though private businesses, again, can ban anyone they please.
It's why YouTube recommended videos by the conspiracist Alex Jones billions of times.
Private businesses can take action against us for saying anything they disagree with.
Dude,
I disagree with
I'm
this.
Fucking this telling you exactly what you're telling.
I disagree with
there's
you.
No defending what you're defending.
No,
you're defending
No, I'm not. You're putting words in my mouth and you're doing
it. You're not defending that?
I'm not.
So you
We're done. Go to break or whatever. This is ridiculous.
This was a time of great turmoil for the hero of this story. He found himself alone and defeated. His audience was dwindling down to nothing, and now more people every day were being silenced and removed.
God, I've tried so hard. I just belong to some other age, I guess. You know, humans don't communicate anymore, or they gibber and jabber about stuff that doesn't matter, and then they send a text message and never communicate with anybody about anything of substance. It's spiritual death. And then I just come to the realization, out of trillions of worlds, we're going to probably die. And everything we did as a species and all of our beauty and all of our goodness will just fail. And we're going to go down the tubes because a bunch of inbred child molesters in Hollywood had some psychotic dream that they wanted to kill everybody. You know, humanity just has to fall. It has, civilization has to fall. It just has to go down. And you know it's going to go down, too. And I just have been a fool trying to prop it up. It's just at a certain point, you're like, God Almighty, this is what death looks like. This is what laziness looks like.
The will to execute anything real. They only execute failure. I want to be loved by CNN, even though I don't watch it.
We have total illegal censorship going on. We have them bragging about it. We have them dead to rights. No one will attack. No one wants to do it. Never took action when all the tools were right there in our hands because we weren't meant to. We couldn't do it. We didn't want it.
Eventually, Alex Jones had no choice but to take his message to the streets. He showed up to a Hillary Clinton rally in a fully armored battle tank, being public enemy number one. He knew he was putting his life in danger. But legends never shy away from danger when it means fighting for what you believe in.
We're coming for you, Hillary. We're coming for the deep state. We're coming for you, criminal. You failed criminal that sold our nation out to the globalists. 1776, baby!
We're going in.
Hillary Clinton is an enemy of the American people! Hillary Clinton is an enemy of the American people!
It never could be proven who fired that missile on that fateful day. I guess we'll never really know. Hell, some folks think it was them old CIA. While others with conspiratorial minds, hell, they think it was Hillary Clinton herself who fired that there missile. One thing we do know for sure is that there Google is one mighty fine search engine.